Hello guys, we are in front of the Soviet submarine of the Cold War. And you know what? Australia a few days ago cancelled the agreement with France for like $40 billion because they understood that French submarines are not the best ones. So I suggest Australian government to take a look to the Soviet submarines. The real stuff, you know. And now we're gonna go inside the submarine, and yes, we are in the beautiful St. Petersburg. Do you have submarines in your city? Like, you know, open for people. Yeah, Russian, Soviet Navy flag, you see.
Let's walk through the whole submarine first, and then I'll show you it in details. This submarine is from the project 613, or Whiskey by the NATO classification. Yes, NATO classification always give weird names for the Russian weapons. This is a middle-sized non-nuclear submarine built in 1954. In fact, the most popular one in USSR. 215 submarines of this project were built in USSR, and also 21 were built by China, which used the Soviet blueprints and Soviet details. These submarines were built in a hurry after the war, so this particular submarine, for example, lacked the beds for sleeping and the heating. The story of this project tells that some of the bases of this submarine was taken from the German submarine U-250, which the Soviets drowned in the Baltic Sea in 1944. In fact, in a Finnish bay, not so far from St. Petersburg. Another interesting fact about the submarines from this project says that in 1989, when the Soviet Union had big economic problems, 17 submarines of this project were given to the PepsiCo Western Company as a payment for its food supply to USSR. Every submarine was sold to PepsiCo for $150,000. Later though, PepsiCo resold them as a scrap metal. But now let me show all the submarine in details.
Foreigners,
where are you from?
Veliky Britannia, Australia,
St. Petersburg.
Here. You got to translate all information. Yes. Yeah? Okay. Yeah, yeah. Only without excursion, because this group will be only in 1600, you see?
I see.
You can go without if you're ready. I explain all information about this one.
Thank you very much.
Okay? Yeah. Listen to me now. This one is ladders that only for tourists here.
Uh-huh.
You see, three steps down. After turn around and following down, like to swimming pool. Not jumping, only go down.
Okay.
Like to swimming pool. Yeah. Okay, I show you now.
You don't need translator. You said I will translate everything.
During excursion, we will be informing to you. If you have some question now, I explain everything information. Because 34 years my service in submarine.
Wow, 34 years.
Right.
As an engineer, yeah. 1, 2, 3.
Have to turn around and follow down.
Uh-huh.
Like this,
I've never gone down a ladder backwards before. Yeah, by the way, guys, interesting information. This submarine was drowned in 1999.
Really?
In Kronstadt. It's an island, former closed Soviet city, Soviet town. And in 2005, some businessman decided to like take it up from the water, and they made a museum here.
Yo, go jumping! Oh, my knees! Fucking hell!
You see, Westerners are not...
I would have been useless as a sailor. They wouldn't give me the job.
It's about some heroes, but it's about another submarine. in Barents Sea.
In the Barents, okay. All right, so what have we got in this room? This. Mali Tovs Inzel Stop.
That's the speed control thing, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Request for the speed.
Yeah.
Fast, slow.
Yeah, guys, my subscribers, don't worry. This Westerners who film here video, it will be all checked before publishing, so they won't steal any technology.
We
any
take
technology.
Russian submarine, and we go attack the Amerikansky. We showed them Russia Pal.
I need to find the room with the secret Russian blueprints. Exactly. I'm taking notes here. There's a YouTube one of these does. Now here we got the serious.
Oh, look at this guy.
Torpedoes.
So I'm now going to climb inside the torpedo tube and Sergei is going to fire me.
Ay, blядь.
Oh, it's okay. How is it that I haven't hit my head yet and I'm 2 meters and you hit yours? So yeah, Sergei's gonna put me inside this torpedo tube and fire me to Veliky Britannia. Cheap journey.
Yeah. But where is the fire like? Oh, God, this is amazing.
Ladies, come to the submarine. I would advise you go to the toilet first because they got.
Does it spin?
It's the Soviet, how it's called?
Washing machine?
No.
R2-D2?
No, Soviet type of. In Star Wars, you know this?
R2-D2, yeah.
Ah, yes? Mm-hmm. Ah, yeah. I didn't know how it's called.
Oh, and here we have the periscope. Wow. Oh, that's really cool.
For our Soviet motherland, SSSR.
Have a look at that, Jason.
Made in 1954 in Leningrad. Oh, wow. Guys, you have a last chance to say sorry to me and send me a lot of money or America will be disappear. 10, 9, 8, go to the links in the description and subscribe to my Patreon or something like, and then like, yeah. Guys, I didn't see it, but it's Kalashnikov here, it looks like a fake one.
Oh, I didn't see it. Is that a real one?
No, it's fake one, but it was here, like,
and two guns, so. Wow.
Заручное оружие.
Could be. Ой, блядь. Yes, guys, and the most. Ай, бля.
Fuck, I hit something, I don't even know what. So yeah, guys, I'm telling you, like, you have a last chance to send me money or all this will go somewhere, you know where, in the western direction. Wow, so long. And I hear the echo, you see, if I speak here, like, I hear the echo. Hello. Russia is great. Russia is great. This is deepness, depths. Counter torpedo apparatus caliber 533 millimeters, 20 or 21 duim. It can shoot electrical or vapor gas torpedoes and also can leave mines. Wow, it's very interesting. In the case of
emergency, this torpedo apparat can be used for entering off, for exiting the submarine for the sailors, you know, so probably you just climb there and go to the water or something, I don't know, but it says like that. Yes, these are different types of torpedoes, as you can see. But this is not a nuclear submarine. And by the way, very interesting information for you guys. We are still in the torpedo section. And you see beds here. And the thing is that sailors slept on these beds. Because there were no enough beds in the submarine. The submarine was made like very simple, very fast, you know, so it's no joke. People slept here on the torpedoes. You see, guys, they even put like some soft things here, so I didn't really hit. I hit it, but it was not painful. Third time. And guys, this is interesting for you, maybe. This is not a torpedo, one of it. It's imitator of the submarine to distract like other foreign submarines.
Sleeping, eating, not
the,
sleeping.
Is the food okay? What is the food?
Borscht. Food is excellent. You see, it's excellent. Of course, everything is canned.
In cans.
It can't.
It's a pelmeni borscht in a can.
Yeah. It's a potato, onion, and everything. Clear, only a little bit salt water. Open here.
It's okay.
Of course, that this is economic electrical city.
Uh-huh.
Everything is put into some pot and prepare everything.
Right.
Provision is good, except of course fruits.
Fruits,
vegetables, and fresh of course. But anything conserved.
Very good. Okay, so thank you very much.
Everything can understand. Okay, keep your health. First of all, guys, always check situation. You know. Okay, see you next time.
So, guys, this is submarine from the outside. S-189. Okay, guys, but if you don't like my Russian accent, you can watch it like with posh British accent, the same review of the submarine, like from BBC. Subscribe to his channel, like
Tall Travels.
Yeah, and he's really tall. But I hit my head 3 or 4 times.
And I didn't hit my head once. I'm used to bending down all the time, being almost 2 meters tall.
Yeah, so links in the descriptions, Tall Travel. He also filmed here. Goodbye.